secret to fried rice, right?
Old rice.
Exactly. It's day old rice.
Yeah.
No, no, I mean it don't hurt. That was the greatest diagonal.
Oh my god.
I completely forgot how to play this game. Oh my god.
Fried rice at home? If you're cooking the rice on the day of the fried rice, you already lost, bro.
Yeah.
You gotta be like, I wanna have fried rice on Thursday, so on Monday you make some rice. And then
it really does make it a lot better.
It completely saves the day.
Wow. Mm-hmm. That was a good move.
I almost got your corpse. Just to,
I keep...
like, take it back.
Throwing my weapon instead of shooting it on accident.
Yeah, I forgot. I've been playing like so many different games that I have like lost my ability to comprehend how to play things.
So, why is it fine to put an egg in ramen and an egg in fried rice, but if you tried to put an egg in spaghetti, you'd be a lunatic?
Woo! You can put an egg in spaghetti. There's carbonara.
Carbonara, yeah, exactly. Sure.
Oh, yeah, that's what that
is. I like eggs on my burgers the most. Those are my favorite.
Egg and steak.
That is pretty good. Yeah, that's steak and eggs. That's good, too.
What no, blew me?
You lived?
Oh, I did.
Something.
Oh, farts.
I guess that was a nade or something.
Yeah, I threw a
Spag Eddie.
Yeah, no, you can put the eggs in pasta. You can make a pasta omelet. Omelets are one of those things that you can put
pasta omelet?
Yeah, get old pasta omelet.
I prefer to call it a omelasta.
Oh my god, I'm terrible at this now.
That's like something I have in a world in an RPG.
Omelasta.
Yeah. The Knights of Omelasta shall make you delicious egg-related meals.
Wow.
I, for whatever reason, I can't get down with the egg burgers. Like,
I love them.
I like my eggs hidden. I like a clandestine egg.
Well, maybe if you didn't know about it, you'd like it.
Have you had an egg burger?
Oh, I've had a fried egg on a burger. I'm not for it. Like, I consider it actually like a punishment. But they're like,
what? It binds it all together.
If they're like, we'll put a fried egg on there for, you know, $1.75 or something, I'm like, how about we both?
That's an expensive fucking egg.
Oh, at a restaurant, that's a reasonable cost for an egg? Whole egg. At the grocery store, I'd be like, what the fuck are you talking about? But
that's 12
oh
eggs
my
right there.
God.
Have you ever gotten? You sometimes you go to a restaurant and you're like, hey, I don't want you to go through the time of like cutting all those potatoes, deep frying them, salting them, and then putting them on the plate. Could you just give me like a handful of lettuce instead? And they're like, yeah, $2.
Jesus.
Yeah.
75 cents.
What the fuck is this level?
For a fried egg. Where do you guys live in freaking the 18th century? This is. I want to.
Egg can cost more than $1.
An egg at a restaurant can't cost more than a fucking dollar?
I think it shouldn't. I think I've paid it, but it shouldn't.
Oh,
I mean,
no, there's bounties!
New York, if you're gonna add, like, anything onto anything, it's gonna be, like, $1 minimum, pretty much.
Anything onto anything.
Yeah, pretty
eggs
much, like...
$6 a dozen in California. Okay, well, I mean, it's getting pricey down there. It's Golden State.
Do they not have a lot of chickens in California or something?
But you know what? If you want to compare the restaurant eggs to the grocery store eggs, go eat your fucking burger at home. You shit stain.
You could just bring a fried egg with you.
Oh, come on.
Bring your own egg?
If I ever went to a restaurant with someone, and they were like, check this out, beating the system. And they pulled a fried egg in a plastic bag out and like laid it across their burger.
They laid an egg.
Speaking of eggs,
I'm not hanging out with you anymore.
Did you see that the Japanese students figured out how to hatch an egg?
Okay, yeah, I did, and I snopes it as a scientist because I said, no fucking way, these 16-year-old Japanese kids are hatching a yolk from an egg into a chick in a fucking sheet of saran wrap. And it
they
is...
They did.
No, hello? No, they didn't. Parts of it are true. However, it was Japanese scientists who did it. And then the news station concocted the story to make it more consumable.
Oh, that makes sense.
They did not just in their high school chemistry lab go, you know what be sweet? Let's just crack an egg over this little heating lamp here and then maybe it'll make a chick. It's like scientists did it with scientist know-how and equipment. And then the news story reframed it. Oh, good job. Good job.
I love the idea of bringing eggs places. Like, I want a vest that's got, like, a bandolier for eggs on the inside.
Joy never being able to get on an airplane.
You've become Frank from Always Sunny.
That's exactly that's, right. Yes,
must focus.
That's literally what he does.
Frank has the best ideas, though.
He really does.
Oh, I got one!
I had to look up that egg thing because my grandma posted the video on Facebook, and she just posted, like, one comment underneath that was, like, amazing. And then I was like,
that egg video was awesome. It
no,
changed my life.
It's yeah, was, not amazing.
Well, I didn't reply. It's nicer for her to believe that there's true magic in the world. But basically, it's bullshit. It's not bullshit. Like, it has
what?
Been done, but it was done, like, in a lab. It was not just, like, a Japanese high school student that was like, yeah, we just fucking cracked an egg for shits and giggles. And
well, they figured it out in a lab, I think, didn't they?
Well, also, the eggs that you buy in the store, you're not... those aren't supposed
See,
to grow into... They're not
That's why
right?
I snopes it. Because no, at first I was like, you can't grow a fucking chicken out of an egg from the store.
Yeah.
Like, that's some, like...
Super fertilized, huh?
I don't even know how.
I don't know how you died and I didn't.
It's because you were crouching, so...
Oh, Lord. God damn it.
Your knees took well, the brunt of it.
It could be that one fertilized one gets through, like, every thousand or something like that.
Oh, it
so
does.
The odds of them picking that one.
That's happened to me, yeah. Before, actually. Where like, I cracked an egg to make, like... Yeah, like, no, one time I cracked an egg to, like, you know, make eggs, and this little, like chicken fetus came out.
That is D-nasty.
Yeah, and I was like, well, you know what? That's not hungry anymore.
Pretty
Turns
traumatizing,
out.
Actually, yeah.
It was
yeah,
fucked up.
Imagine
was
how the
too.
Fetus felt.
Well, yeah, I guess so.
Get no snows.
I don't feel comfortable eating eggs anymore after watching that video.
That's pretty weird.
It was
That's
disgusting
why I like my
looking.
Eggs to be hidden, man. I like eggs, but, like, only if I don't know that they're there.
I don't think they're that. I mean, I don't know. There's eggs. Eggs are a lot like potatoes.
Yes.
You can make them into like a million different things.
Oh,
you know?
I'm aware.
You shouldn't live in secrecy.
I've had quiches and frittatas. You know, I've had carbonaras and omeletas and papas rojas, huevos rancheros, etc.
You had papas rojas?
I've had papas rojas.
And then
those rojas are big. Though.
Those are red potatoes.
Yeah, I was gonna say, that's to do with eggs at all.
Although, there's one time.
Wow,
good
shot.
When I went down to Miami, and I was
Sorry,
very young.
Anytime
you say,
I'm only getting my ass
Miami,
kicked.
It has to be followed by bitch. So, could you stop the story?
I'm sorry, yes. I was in Miami, bitch. And,
alright, it's a start.
But. So there was a Spanish food restaurant, or Cuban food, something like that, and I had been taking, you know,
yes.
Spanish classes, so I was a smartass, and, but I saw on the menu, it said Ropa Vieja.
Board for life, Mecco Gecko.
Underword.
Under it said the English translation for shredded beef, but then I was like, wait a second, Ropa Vieja, that just means old clothes. Are they serving me old clothes? Or what's happening here? I assume it's a colloquialism. But
yeah, way better that time.
I think it's of old shoes and socks.
Yeah, just give me a pair of jeans that the guy was wearing back.
Boiled from under a bridge.
Yeah.
I don't like this one.
Oh, farts.
Well, we were on the topic of traumatizing things a moment ago. I wanted to mention that I found a house centipede in my house for the first time. And if you don't know what those are,
God.
They're actually
those are creepy.
Straight out of hell.
Yeah.
Centipedes are really poisonous too, actually.
They could not exist in the world, and the fact that I found one is a nightmare.
Yeah, did you...
if I find another one, I have to leave.
I found a big spider in my room as a kid, and I never slept there again for 10 years. I moved to another room.
It's just moved out.
I moved to my grandfather's old room.
Wolf, Grim, and Sub the Tank. Thank you very much for the resubs.
The, Nick, actually, in that vein, where was yours?
In the hallway outside?
Dead by Daylight's next, guys.
I found one crawling on my fucking ceiling. And I was... Like, I was, like, laying down, and I saw it, and I'm just like, what is this demon spawn that has entered into my life?
It shouldn't exist.
Yeah, I actually spent, like, a good hour trying to murder it in ways that I wouldn't have to interact with it.
Oh,
yeah,
fuck!
Me too! I couldn't stop staring at it. I was like, what do I do?
Yeah, it was...
I couldn't come up with a good excuse to not be able to touch it.
I put a towel on a broom, and I tried bashing it. But then what happened was it fell down into my bed, and then I freaked
what?
Out.
What? What?
Yeah, I ran away.
And that was then, amazing.
And, eventually it died, but it was
I was so lucky when I hit it. I only had to hit it once, and I got it perfectly. Because if I had to chase it, I was so terrified.
Yeah.
Yes! Wow! That was a good one.
We used to have some like big-ass centipedes in my college house. But
oh, no.
Mostly took that as, like, this is an actual shithole.
Right, yeah. Well, I mean, centipedes just show up. Like, there's no, like, if you get roaches, that's like, oh, you've been fucking up. But I think centipedes just, like, appear sometimes.
Yeah, spontaneously, wow. Out of thin air. Like, where did it come from? It was quite large.
Yeah, they're
I don't even
massive.
Like little centipedes. What the fuck is this level? Nick, please.
What?
This is your doing, isn't it? Did you make this
yeah.
level?
Yeah, I made this level.
I didn't know you made this one.
Yeah, I did.
Yeah. Yeah, I was just drinking.
Fun. Just have like a ton of shit just everywhere.
Drinking, margarita.
GFYW 6 months in a row. Welcome back. Thank you for the resub.
Actually, speaking of drinks that are delicious and alcoholic. Well, yeah, that's not alcoholic.
If you leave it long enough in prison.
I don't know if they're serving Thai iced tea. Like anywhere.
I want a prison Thai iced tea. That sounds.
I
great.
Thought you said high C.
No.
No, I mean, well, they're probably serving that, yeah. No, Tequila Sunrises? You guys ever remember Tequila Sunrise?
I think I fought him in Metal Gear Solid Rising.
It's fucking delicious, man, and it's beautiful. And
yeah,
yes, it's a gnarly
nice.
Drink, but it's good. It's so good.
You can beat that AK! Oh, yeah!
Oh, nice.
I just want him to win because he's got the least points.
That's true. I made prison wine out of sugar and Welch's grape juice. It was fucking terrible. Well, I think that's kind of like the price
goes
you pay,
without
right?
saying.
I mean, I technically made some artisan prison cider with like Allen's apple juice, and then you leave it in a glass jar with a little bit of like a lets the air out on top. I forget what it's called. But.
We used to drink this stuff that. We used to drink this in high school when I was above the age of 21. And
of course.
It was, we used to call it bum wine because it was what the hobos used to drink.
Out of their
asses. Oh, okay.
Yeah, well, so. They'd
spray it out of their asses into each other's mouths.
Yeah,
we're so close.
Like,
oh.
A glass, like a little tequila flask, like a glass tequila flask type of thing.
What is a tequila flask?
Well, I mean, like, or, you know, I mean, I meant vodka, actually. You know, like how vodka comes in, like, that little
flask? Oh, way different.
Out of a yeah, Mickey. Yeah, exactly, yeah. Yeah
fuck!
A mouse?
No!
And,
you're drinking mouse wine.
But the thing is, it was very disgusting. It was very gross. And we used to hang out with a couple of homeless people because it was fun.
No,
and
Rob,
because it was fun.
But there was one of them. One of them was very adamant about the fact that he believed that they invented that stuff to kill the homeless.
Is he drinking it?
Yeah, oh, he's just drinking it.
He's a man of principles, then.
I mean, you know. It was a dollar for a thing to get you drunk, so I mean, you know.
So somebody said I don't have to worry at all about house centipedes, and somebody else said they lay like 60 eggs, so I don't know who to believe.
Who lays 60 eggs?
In your ears.
Oh, well.
Oh, nice.
They lay 60 eggs in your ears while you're sleeping.
Yeah, sorry. Did you know when you're sleeping you'll eat at least 21 spiders every hour?
21
not hour, it's hour. Like yeah. It's like 2 a year or something.
It's,
I don't think
it's not actually true.
No, that's not actually a thing.
You guys gotta go Snopes. You gotta Snopes this stuff.
No,
this
I said it'd be funny because I think it's a stupid thing, like just that people say.
Even if that were true, how do you test that at all? Like, it's
and how do you
impossible.
Average it?
There's no way to possibly
no,
test that.
No, there's no ground there.
Also, I was laughing initially because I saw some comment that I just thought was so curt that it was funny, which was, yo, hobo
all shall fear! 18 months in a row, welcome back a year and a half, man!
Man, this whoever that guy is, he knows some shit.
Oh, I guess I disarmed you, but did not kill you.
Yeah, get sucked. I mean, fucked.
They're saying that they'll eat roaches? I've never had a roach here, thankfully, but I would honestly rather have roaches than house centipedes. I know that's a ridiculous thing to say.
No,
but...
it's not ridiculous. House centipedes have a real marketing problem. Like, would you trust the police if they had 100 legs?
Probably. Probably trust them more.
Wait, I gotta think about that. I want to know how they fit all those legs under their torso.
They got sleeves. They got leg sleeves.
They got leg sleeves.
Their pants just have 998 more spots for legs than ours do.
That's a tailor's nightmare.
What is Taylor's nightmare?
Like a tailor.
Taylor's nightmare is like to have 100 legs.
Oh, a tailor.
Like a cloth maker.
Taylor Swift, the cloth maker.
Yeah, Taylor Swift, the cloth maker.
We call them
Taylor Swift, the fresh maker.
Oh, I went for it.
It's better with life.
I went for it. You come here. I'm gonna squishy squish. Oh yeah.
We call them pant romancers here.
Do you?
Yeah.
They romance your pants right off.
They pants romance.
They pants romance. Yeah.
Yes! Okay. Earthworm Jim for the win.
Taylor Swift's nightmare is someone doing a cover of her song.
With 100 legs.
Oh.
Yeah.
How does Nick, the only one unscathed?
I know, man.
He's the net master.
Nets are kind of my thing.
Yeah. Trooper, thank you as well.
Love nets.
Oh, daddy.
Dang it.
Well, then.
Oh. What's going on here?
Oh, my spine. Oh, but anyway, what I was drinking was peach tea. Snapple peach tea.
Yeah.
Just so delicious. Good.
Yeah, I know.
Fucking!
Right? As we've discussed, we don't really have... Snapple doesn't have a stranglehold in Canada like they do in the United States.
Snapple's too sweet for me a lot of the time.
That's agree. Yeah. And the peach tea is probably like the worst offender of that, but I still really enjoy it. But I will say the tea that I drink most is the Arizona green tea, which is still a little too sweet, but it's not very sweet compared to like everything else.
Wiggle 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 wiggle.
It like tries to make you think that it's not terrible for you, but it still is.
Yeah.
Wiggle 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 wiggle. Nice.
I didn't see the
fucking mime.
What a round.
Actually, Arizona iced tea was like.
Oh, wow! God. Come on!
Buying that in America made me realize where people in Japan are coming from.
They're
like,
$2
for a soda? What is this? Like, the Ritz? Because you can get, like, all-you-can-drink Arizona iced tea for, like, a
dirty
nickel in the United States.
Arizona iced tea is, like, that was, like, a godsend when I was a young lad going out and playing the sports ball. And you would go to a deli in between
the
rounds.
The can for a dollar is huge.
Oh, yeah. The giant-ass can for a dollar.
He's got everything the body needs after a...
Dude, it got me through so many days of work. I was so happy that that's all I had to spend was a dollar to be hydrated for that day.
Yeah, that's great.
Even though it's hydrated full of sugar and corn syrup.
I've been a lot
you
of
get more
yeah.
in that can than you do if you got a
full
dollar
bunch.
Bottle of water outside.
That's, like, debatable.
No, it's not.
Like a chili dog.
Somebody just said there's a category on Twitch called social eating.
It's mukbang.
Is that real? Can you confirm?
Social eating?
Eating?
Social eating?
Let's get social. I just wanted my sweet sneakers.
Oh, I thought I was a different duck.
NL, do you remember those little Canadian drinks called Chubby? Hell yeah, dude. Chubby pineapples all day.
You got Chubby?
I did play handball, by the way, forget hype. Sorry, go on.
My grandpa used to drink those Chubby sodas all the time. And he would... basically, it was a soda that where the can, instead of being, I don't know, 12 ounces or whatever it is in your fucked up country, would be like two-thirds of that size. So you'd be like, it's about moderation. But then you'd have to drink more of them.
Chubby soda, huh?
Chubby soda, look it up, man. And they were actually pretty bad, in my opinion.
It's like when you get those big jars of cheese balls, thinking like, oh, I won't need cheese balls for like, you know, 10 years. Turns out,
you never
need the entire jar of cheese balls in like an hour.
Just eat a lot of cheese balls.
Ah! Oh! I'm trying to do the duck action. Get it?
What do you guys think about Yoo-hoo?
It's alright. I gotta be in the mood.
Not a fan.
Alright, chocolate dairy simulant.
Whatever, it's chocolate drink.
It probably is made from, like, milk concentrate and water.
Wow, yeah, I thought I got the swing off first.
They can't call it ice cream, they have to call it, like, frozen dessert.
Where do you get this map pack? Nick made a lot of these maps, my friend.
Yeah, I made about 20 of them. You can grab the map pack if you want. Oh, I just went in the stream there. If you go to my Steam profile,
wow.
I think there might also be a link on my Twitch page. You just gotta basically subscribe to it, and it'll send you, like, the 20-something map. And you travel by bones for the subscription. And again, I'm going to read all the donations at the end. Thank you, everybody that has.
Oh,
I shouldn't want to talk over everybody for too long.
This is,
Yeah! From downtown!
How much is a 500 milliliter Coke in Canada or the United States?
I'd say, like... Well, I don't even know.
Dollar and change.
Yeah, I would say like a little over a dollar.
Is it a can or the bottle?
No, it would be like the bottle that is one size above normal.
Oh, so like a one. How
do you get at a pizza parlor?
Oh, yeah, that's like, that'd be like $1.50.
That was awesome.
Like dollar and bit.
Cheaper than water, which is just so frustrating.
That's my favorite map.
It's not cheaper than tap water.
You know what pisses me off is the waters that are like, you know, like artisanal water, and it, you know, it's like $3 for, like, people used to drink like smart water and stuff, and fucking
just
like, oh, I have Fuji water, I have rain water from Mount Fuji. Like, firstly, you have no fucking idea if it actually is, but it could just be tap water.
The Mount Fuji water sucks.
Nestle Corporation always.
Yeah. And then secondly, like, why do you want, what, even if it is, what are you getting out of the rainwater from
it's
the
it's just untouched by nature. It's not that great.
No,
I call BS on
it's
anyone thinking water difference, other than how chlorinated or pH it is.
Yes. I've never had a water and been like, oh, this is some fucking sick water.
Filtration. Offer filtration.
This is gonna change the game right here.
What up, Hutz?
You
can
taste, like, some differences that I'm sure are based on, like, you know, mineral concentration or something, but I'm mostly like, you know, this water is like a water out of water, and then, like, this water is like a slightly different water out of water.
I don't even have a bounce pad down here, Nick.
What?
Oh, you wait. I have a jetpack. I'm an idiot.
I want a bounce pad too. We were in Iceland. One of the things they tell you, like, their tourism board is fucking crazy about is that we have the best water on the fucking planet ever. And, like, you were on, like, Iceland Air. They're like, check this shit out. Iceland water. Are you going to say thank you? This shit is like a precious resource. And I consumed a lot of Icelandic water.
Oh, okay. I'll take it.
Just tastes like water to me, baby.
I will say that I do notice the difference in taste in water, though. Like, I've had water from places, like, the water out of even a water bottle in California is, like, it's kind of gross to my taste. It's like, it's very, very milky, it's basty, you know?
Basty, like, huh? Wow!
Talk about how the water is milky, I want to hear more.
It just tasted kind of milky, I don't know. Maybe it's like a...
Clouded? You mean like clouded?
No, I mean, like, it tasted like it was more... Base.
From the
like
udder
it had
of a
some,
milk.
Like, as opposed to acid. You know what I mean? Like, it's lower
I don't
on
know
the
what basic
pH.
Is, but I don't see how that correlates to milky.
Well, milk is very base, right? I think. I haven't taken chemistry.
I didn't win at all, I thought I won one! Cucaracha of an AK-47, 8 months in a row, welcome back!
It does taste different from different places.
I don't think viscous is a good word for that either.
No, I wouldn't say
water
it's
should have the same viscosity.
Yeah, if you're drinking viscous water,
then you're
all,
dealing with my issue. Then you shouldn't be dealing with my issue.
That sounds bad, yeah.
Oh, I died.
No, but I mean, you know.
The grappling hook is still going and hitting it.
Water has a different taste in different places. Oh, fuck.
Hey!
Backwater versus front water.
Water
alkaline.
Sucks.
Maybe it's alkaline.
Better.
Alkaline. Oh,
maybe it's basty.
Maybe it's alkaline.
I'm sorry, I don't know alkaline in the chat. Excuse me.
Milk has a pH of 6.5.
Ooh. There you go.
That's nearly neutral, but technically Rob is correct.
Yeah, that's, I mean, that's sort of what I'm saying. It's kind of, it's more to that.
The Beastie Boys.
I think you fear the cute ones for 2 months in a row.
I'm not, like, going over there, so.
I don't, I can't, okay. Here we go, here we go, here we go.
Oh, you drop a rock on his head. Oh, no.
Rock is my only weapon. You son of a snarkle. Hup! Oh!
That was so rough.
It's my only weapon! It's my only... I jumped! You still got my toes!
They're arguing so much about a thing that we've already settled.
Wait, what are they arguing about?
I'm not making some sort of factual claim. I'm
I was
just
also
saying
incorrect. Acids are under 7, not bases.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Way to go, Rob.
I mean, I don't know. I even said, I don't know.
No!
Oh, wow. Okay, oh, he's still on fire.
Acidic. You
son
win.
Of a biscuit.
It's slightly acidic. I don't think we care that much.
Yeah, really. Like, I'm just saying, like, it tastes a little bit different in California.
Oh, well, you
how
fucked.
How does it taste in Miami, bitch?
Can you just stay there forever? Oh, no. That was a great grenade.
What are you gonna do about that? Oh no! Ah! Oh.
Tell Rob he needs to stop dropping acid. Okay, there you go.
Well, yeah, I mean that's probably
stop dropping slightly acid.
That's damn
like,
it!
I've been trying to cut back on my acid. So I've been taking nearly acid for like 6 months.
Yeah, just only half drop on a sheet, you know.
Oh fuck!
Wow, he's got a gun! Didn't see that.
Aren't there some places in the world where acid is, like, legal? Like, LSD is legal?
Probably.
I know there's that one place where they made all drugs legal because it was such a problem, and it actually lowered the amount of people using it when they did
Chicago?
That.
That makes sense.
No, it was, like,
I
another country.
It
was, like, a small country.
Joking.
Might have been Chicago. I'm, like, an hour and a half away from there.
That's Portugal, right?
I met a guy outside of Laser Quest that was trying to sell me a pound of weed. And I was like, I think I'm good on that.
That was definitely a
problem. Oh, I thought you were reading chat. That happened to you?
Yeah, it happened to me. They got out of their car, and I jokingly was like, oh, that smells nice. And they were like, yo, I got a pound for 3,000. And I was like, you're going to rob
what?
Me and kill me.
I mean, 3,000, that's like...
Trying to rob me.
I was just gonna go out and play laser tag, but instead I've become, you know, the 10th largest supplier of marijuana in our district.
3,000 is like, that's probably some bad marijuana, if I'm being honest here, right now, for a pound.
I don't know, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know either. We don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, too touche. Quick draw.
Yeah, Chad, I'm with you. I'm trying to do the conversion from gram to ounce to pound. And I don't really understand where. Like, 3,000 might be a deal. It might be a total ripoff. I might be off by like a factor of 10.
I have no clue.
Well, it's 16 ounces, right?
So a pound is 16 ounces?
Yeah, I didn't know that.
How many grams are in an ounce?
That's actually a pretty good deal, I think, then.
Oh, there's 454 grams in a pound. Of course.
Hey, grats, Benny boy. It's the last day of high school. Enjoy the rest of your life.
If an ounce is 300 and you're getting 16 of those for 3,000, then you can make profit there.
Yeah, but like a $300 ounce is like...
Did you test to see if it is more acidic or more basic?
Just stop.
Anyway, they tried to rob me and kill me, I'm pretty sure. So that was the moral of the story.
don't buy weed, you'll be robbed and killed.
Don't buy weed from unknown strangers that are trying to sell you like extravagant amounts of it.
Yeah. Just don't buy a pound of weed anyway.
Actually, you know what?
As far as he's concerned, don't buy weed.
We canceled each other out!
This reminds me of when when we bought our car and we walked in and the dude was like, "Hey, you like this?" And he
wow!
He pointed at like a Ford GT, and I was like, yeah, it's nice. And he's like, well, it's like 75 grand if you want it.
I'm gonna come in here for a great deal.
You're gonna try to like impulse sell me a fucking sports car.
That's 75 grand.
It's only 75 G's.
That was his opening pitch?
You got any spending money?
Fuck. He was just trying to like bond, but I don't know anything about cars. Like he made a joke and he's like, you guys are finally done with the 32 window coupe, right? And I realize now he's talking about the bus. But I was just like, I just laughed and then was like, yeah, you know, just want a car.
People making jokes like that will always catch me off guard.
I can't believe that hit me.
What the hell you're talking about?
In my head, I was like, what the fuck is a 32 window?
Everybody makes jokes like that.
I don't want a car with 32.
Well, we almost won last round. We're getting our ass kicked this one.
Four, and then a windshield and a rear window. That's like, that's fine by me.
That's like the dad at a restaurant who's like, well, you could just give it to me for free, right?
Yeah. No price on it. Is this free? And I always like look down on people that said that at the grocery store. But then I bought something like 2 weeks ago with no price tag on it. And she was like, I guess this is free. And I was like, do I hate you? Or like, you're just trying to get through the retail life.
That's a lot of duck sauce over there.
One of us all died simultaneously using swords.
Yeah. I mean, that's why the samurai died out. I was about to say the Japanese, and that would have been...
That would have been really, really bad.
That was both incorrect and probably right.
Tom Cruise.
Yeah, exactly.
Thanks, Lynn. Lynn said she'll translate the car talk for me.
Oh, okay. I could use the translation as well, to be honest with you.
At least someone around here likes it as well.
It's okay, I got a jetpack.
Oh, that's cheating. She's from Ireland.
I think they'd be more likely to dislike Bono because he's acting above his station.
Yeah, that's where I thought we landed on that. Not that he was a
headshot.
Fan,
yeah.
But she was okay with
Bono.
Like, oh.
What about Bon Jovi?
No, don't even start with
me. Like, what about Bon Mick Jovi?
How did you get the Mets?
Does anyone actually like Bon Jovi? Can we talk? Or is it just like, I like to get drunk? And
I like David Bowie.
If Living on a Prayer comes on, I like to say, whoa.
Yeah. I like Dead or Alive.
I'm sure there are people, like, you know, 40-year-old moms who, like, still listen to Bon Jovi, like, non-ironically. I mean, I don't even really listen to it ironically when I'm drinking.
I don't want to talk about Bon Jovi again.
Is it too much? Is it hitting too close to home?
Getting above his station wagon. Vin says my mom likes Bon Jovi.
Oh, there you go. It's mom stuff.
Aaron, thank you for 18 months in a row. I just ran into the lava for you because I was looking at that. I'm going to blame you completely. Thank you, Aaron.
I was wrong.
Oh! Wow.
Rob hit the nail on the head with the 40-year-old mom's thing.
Yeah, if you're going to look at people who like Bon Jovi unironically, that's going to be your target demographic there.
Okay, but does anybody actually like the song Jack and Diane by John Cougar Mellencamp?
Oh, secret. Oh, double secret. That was like
there.
That scene in Inglourious Bastards.
One where they're all like in the restaurant or whatever?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
See, that's how much like that scene it was that you could tell.
Yeah, it is Portillo's, yeah. Yeah, that Portillo's is like a hot dog place.
Whoa.
My girlfriend got back home and dropped me some Portillo's off downstairs.
What's the Chicago deep dish place that everybody's like they expect you to know it even if you're not from Chicago?
But what I'm told from my girlfriend is that it's not actually like a Chicago's deep dish isn't actually like a thing. They like pizza, and they have like a Chicago-style pizza, but it's not actually deep dish. Like, people from Chicago don't actually like it.
Is it called Lou Manigotti's? Something like
what?
That?
Lou
no.
Manigotti's.
They actually like hot dogs. They're more particular about hot dogs than anything. Illuminati's?
Pretty close. Yeah, Illuminati's.
All right, drop your YV triangles in.
I'd go there. I think we just found a new chain to open up.
They probably have some pretty good pizza. Like, I'm sure the Illuminati would know how to make a good pie. I want to see. I don't like deep dish, but I've only had it. Well, no, I've only had it in New York. So I mean, I don't know. Like, maybe it's great. I gotta go to Chicago and try.
If I'm in the mood for pasta, then or like lasagna, then I'll eat deep dish.
Fuck.
But
you like Sicilian pizza though?
Sicilian?
Yeah.
Yeah, like with the sausages and stuff? It's really good.
No, it's like it's the square pizza. It's like thicker and big.
I like
square
any
pizza.
Deep dish pizza is like my least favorite of pizza, but I'll eat it because I love pizza. Wow, those bounce pads of doom. Wow. Did you make this map?
Yeah, I did.
You son of a bitch. I knew it.
It says in the bottom right which one's
does it?
When it starts.
What if people call it a pizza pie? It is technically a pie.
In fact, in one way, is it a pie?
I don't know about that.
Well, that's just what it is. Like, that's.
Let's go through the morphological constraints of a pie.
I think we have, yeah. Well, there's a crust underneath, and then there's filling on the top. That's pretty much
pretty standard pie stuff.
Yeah, and that's what pizza is.
Let me think about this. There's a crust underneath, and then fillings on the top.
Wow.
Is it a face sandwich?
What?
Is an open-faced sandwich a pie?
Oh, I think this is the exact way that we went about this conversation last time. No, because it's not a
Fuck.
Crust.
What are you talking about? What if I used an end piece?
Bread isn't a crust.
It's got a crust.
Okay.
But it's not a pastry crust.
No, I will refine your argument. A meal in a bread bowl, is that a pie?
You tell
answer?
Me?
You're the expert here. I'm refining your side of the debate here, and honestly, I don't know. I'm not sure. Maybe it is.
Aw.
Maybe you could consider that a pie.
No!
What about a McDonald's apple pie?
I just wanted out of that corner the whole time.
McDonald's apple pie. Is that a pie? Or is it
those...
a pie? The thing with pie in the title is not a pie.
Those are more of like...
Well, if that is a pie, then a hot pocket's a pie.
It's like a pantry.
Hot pie kit.
I think it's a foldover.
I don't know what a foldover is.
It's a folder
like a pasty?
Pie.
It's a folder pie?
Oh my god, I just wanted
like
to drop it.
Pasty.
Yeah, exactly. Like
what about a shepherd's pie? No crust? Is it a pie?
Crust on top, or is that...
That's it's roasted potatoes on top.
Which is the one with mashed potatoes and which is the one with crust?
The shepherd's pie is mashed potatoes.
Yes. Yeah. I don't know if there's one with a crust
I had it.
I know cottage pie is a shepherd's pie with beef instead of lamb. Well, no, see, but cottage pie is just beef instead of lamb. That's what cottage pie is.
What about a cream pie?
There's one with a crust on top because I ate it.
Well, I mean...
It's baked to be a pie.
Oh, okay. That seems like a fair...
What about a Cornish pasty? I don't even know what that is, Jay Welsh, but I had to throw it out there.
It's like a proper Hot Pocket.
Yeah, that's...
Don't say proper as if you're from continental Europe. It's a proper Hot Pocket.
I'm sorry,
well, that's
I picked
what the
up
Hot
a couple
Pocket
of those.
Is based upon, so that's fair to say, I think.
It helped me relate to my girlfriend better by saying things like proper.
Everyone's still alive and I'm scared! Where's the key?
Wait, which one of you fuckers is this?
Me.
I did a double head bounce and
Want some dick? Do you desire dicking?
I don't desire your dicking! Oh! Take you with me, baby!
I shot the sword out of the air!
Then said, don't you dare compare Cornish pastries to a Hot Pocket.
It's actually a pastry.
Ah, tried to jump.
Also, why is it a pasty and not a pastry?
Here's the answer, if you're from England or anywhere in the United Kingdom, because we fucking invented the language. And you gotta be like, hey, why do all your words have like 8 extra vowels when you don't talk like that anymore? Well,
yes!
When we invented your country, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
The language isn't called American, blah, blah, blah.
I speak American, honestly.
Oh. That's what I call fast food.
I speak that boy.
Oh, is it pasty? Okay, well, I mean, we also have things called pasties here, which are spelled the exact same way, so I
put them on your nipples.
Yeah, it's nipple. It's a nipple sticker.
We're in a rush to one-up each other.
Yeah, so, you know, forgive
what?
Me.
How?
What?
How?
Is it?
How?
If you're from England, and you meet someone, and you say, hello, governor.
Hello, governor.
What are you talking about?
You're a governor.
They're saying hello to the governor. I mean, it's pretty self-explanatory.
I didn't even know you could throw those hammers.
I didn't know you could say hello to a governor.
Goodbye, governor. Why don't you say goodbye?
If we were like, hey man, what's up? You'd be like, yo, mayor, what's up? Yo, local comptroller.
That's gotta be from a movie or something.
Well, I think actually, like, governor might have a different connotation over there as well.
Is not like, someone who governs?
I believe it might have a colloquial connotation.
Is it like a subservient dominant thing? Like you're saying you're in a position above someone or below someone?
Maybe.
A senpai kind of thing?
Oh, that was close.
It's a senpai.
It's a European senpai.
Please, no. I prefer European
kind of
cream
pie we haven't discussed
personally.
Yet.
Nobody says that. That's out of Oliver Twist.
I like this ducking thing you're doing.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Thank you, Sleepy Arcane.
I won! Oh no!
Hello, Governor! Cheers, love! The cavalry's here!
Oh.
Yeah! Yeah! I like what's going on over here!
No one says it anymore. Do you think we live in the industrial era?
Well, technically speaking,
it's an actual era, though.
we live in the post-industrial area.
The area of post-industrialism.
We live in the age of computers.
Hello, Governor.
There are some places that should be post-industrial, but totally aren't. I was reading about this place in Wolf.
Stay away from my house!
There's this town in Russia that was under siege by a super pack of 400 wolves.
Super pack?
What?
Means something very different here.
Yeah,
I thought they were made illegal by President Bernie Sanders.
No, they were appealed.
Too soon. But, the super packs of wolves apparently exist.
Imagine living in a small town in the middle of Iceland, Russia, where not
actual
Iceland.
Iceland,
Russia.
I mean, you know, the land of ice is more what I'm getting at here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but
it's actually Greenland, Russia.
But then, and then just like a pack of 400, like an army of fucking 400 wolves just shows up. What do you do in that situation?
You fucking amnesia it. You put all the bottles on the end of your knuckles and you punch.
Where do you hide 400 wolves at?
Like, day one, there was like one wolf. You're like, oh, fuck, it's a wolf. No big deal. Like, day two, there were like eight wolves. People were like, something weird's going on. And then day three, there were 400 wolves and they're like, we should have stopped them 2 days ago.
Like I'm saying, where do you hide them at? Like, how do you not notice 400 wolves? Is it a big place? They have some kind of cave.
They probably were living in like out in the tundra wilderness. Like they probably just got electricity in like 2014.
The wolves?
Or yeah. Well, how do you think they organized, Nick? You think they together? I mean, they gotta get telephones and stuff coordinated.
I'm out of bullets. You're not. Oh my gosh.
Find wolves for my meals.
They have a bat cave. Oh, it all makes sense
and
now.
My granddad is a doggo.
There was actually
he's
speaking
a
of
dog, a big bad dog.
Speaking of bat caves, apparently there was a Jesus.
That was the best kill.
That was pretty good.
I've never seen that before.
But there was a project in World War II where the United States sewed explosives into bats, and they were going to drop them over Japan, and then they have time bombs,
okay.
And then it would blow up Japan.
What?
That goes through walls.
Yeah. Hold up. Why wouldn't they just drop the bombs?
Well, that's actually what happened. Is
I remember the story. Yes.
Well. No, I mean, like, the project was canceled because it was taking too long and cost too much money, and then the Manhattan Project was finishing anyway, so they were like, well, this seems like a...
Stop cutting open all the bats, we never needed to do it in the first place.
You made me throw the grenade.
Plan A. We've invested all of this intellectual resource, you know, financial capital into building a bomb more horrible than anything the world has ever created. It's going to shock and awe them into surrender. Plan two, cut open a bunch of bats and drop bombs inside of the bats.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's genius.
What are we going to do?
Well, apparently they're like incendiary bombs, and they would drop them over like wooden houses, and the bats would like stay in the houses for a while, and they would be time bombs, and then they'd all explode at the same time.
The reality is the bats never tried flying with a bomb embedded in them before, so they're gonna immediately fall to the ground.
Yeah, that would be pretty hilarious.
Yeah, I don't think you can like take the weight ratio from a flying animal and like mess it up. And expect them to fly.
Thought that shit through properly.
I mean, this is like the same, you know, era of people that did invent the atomic bomb. So I assume they had some sort of scientific minds.
The atomic bomb and the bad idea were not from the same people.
there was
some general who's
like, check it out.
Just because it's in the same time zone.
And then there was another dude who was like the son of the lieutenant general or something. Who was like, bats can fly already. Like, why are we wasting time? Did you know that the only like bombing on American soil during World War II was like this Japanese kite or like a zeppelin basically that they just flew over the Pacific Ocean and set a bunch of like Portland on fire. Not Portland, Oregon. But
oh really?
Yeah. There was one known casualty or something like that. Dropped a bunch of firebombs on Oregon.
Pretty fucked up.
Oregon never did anything to anyone.
Yeah, that's true. Like, who cares about Oregon?
Well, okay, even now. Well, now you're just insulting them.
I mean, what do they gain from
Oh,
that?
Right, and also, I may have forgotten about Pearl Harbor, apparently. One of two bombings on American soil. Hey, that wasn't on American soil. Every single one of those bombs landed in the harbor or on a nautical vessel of some sort. Don't blow up. Ah,
where's
shit.
Where's the freaking key at?
Other than that.
Oh, fuck.
I don't know, the key could be anywhere.
Oh, daddy.
People just get angry at me for talking. Somebody just said, fuck you, Rob, eat shit. I don't even
know. Wow. I mean, I can agree. I'm just kidding.
Yeah, I mean, I could eat some shit.
I could eat.
Doesn't seem like the worst idea.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Check it out. Why it didn't become a U.S. state until, like, 1954. Suck on that, wrongos. You doyoys!
I'm out of bullets! No! What? I had like two shots!
All I'm saying is, if this were EU4 and they like, you know, besieged Oregon, that'd be like 1% war score.
Yeah, have you ever tried to like take over America in one of the like Victoria or Hearts of Iron games? Yeah, you get like two states done and you're like, it's not worth it.
Yeah, yeah, I mean, pretty much.
Quicksilver. Thank you as well. Didn't the Japanese occupy the Aleutian Islands for some time? I think there was like a Zero crashed in one of those like Alaskan Aleutian Isles or something like that.
Really?
Yeah, and then they like went hunting for it. That's one of those like History Channel things they do all the time. The Zero was never found. Maybe Adolf Hitler built a megastructure on it and flew it to the dark side of the moon.
You did a...
In Argentina.
There's a movie about that.
Hitler's megastructures?
It's called Nazi Zombies in Space or something like that. Not even joking.
Oh,
how about
God.
Ginger Dead Man versus Evil Bomb?
I prefer that looked pretty sick. Naughty Zombies in Space.
Oh!
Nautical Zombies in Space.
Yeah, Nautical Zombies in Space.
Don't they have to be underwater?
Space vessels count like water.
Yeah,
I think it works the same.
That's true, yeah.
Space is not like water. It's not superfluous or whatever.
It's a fluid.
It's not superfluous.
Yeah. You know what I mean.
Yeah. Would you guys ever?
Hey, at least I got you that time.
Perfluorocarbon.
Sorry. What?
Would you guys ever like breathe through a perfluorocarbon?
What the fuck is a perfluorocarbon?
It's a liquid that you can breathe.
Oh,
like Abyss!
In the Ava suit.
Mm-hmm. Like the Abyss.
in the movie The Abyss. Yes.
Yes. Yeah. That was real. They actually used an actual.
No, that was a movie.
No.
I mean, not that. Yeah, the movie was fake, but I mean,
Have you seen the end of it? I'm pretty sure it's a movie.
The scene. But I mean, like, would that freak you out? Like, I feel like it would freak me out.
Obviously, it would freak everyone out.
I think it would probably be like one of the most freaky things ever. You'd be like, I'm breathing. Like water, my body was not designed for this. I'm having troubles.
But like,
it
still
hurt like hell when it went into your like down your throat and esophagus and everything.
I don't know. Maybe. I never.
Your body just has to remember it.
Well, I mean, technically you are. In the embryo, you do. Oh God damn it!
I don't want to.
I just died because BattleNet was like, "Hey, BattleNet requires an update."
No, you're not dead, man. You're a living corpse.
Am I?
Oh yeah.
Now you're dead.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm dead now.
What the fuck is going on here? What? I mean...
He outthought me.
I'll join you.
Okay, I meant your trachea. I'm sorry. I'm not...
Your esophagus? Oh, I see. Instead of esophagus.
You don't ventilate in utero. Okay, just remember back to when I was a zygote and then later a fetus.
I mean, come on, man. Everybody knows that.
Like riding a bike, man.
Apparently, someone said, and I take chat's word as word of God, but apparently you can't breathe in it for more than like an hour or two without it hurting your diaphragm. That's like the vibe. Yeah.
You can only pilot the Ava for 2 hours max.
Probably. Is the Ava? Is this from Neon Genesis Evangelion?
Yeah, that's the one.
That mindfuck of a show.
With fluids and you breathe through it.
All right, you know what? You know what, Mr. Ducky? Okay, all right.
Oh man, you're still in the vibe.
Dan Giesling is playing Star Citizen.
There's a fucking surprise.
I think he's actually from space, and he relates to that game.
Could be. I can see it.
Leave me alone and... Oh, you have a gun.
Yeah.
I just wanted to open this nice rocket up for us.
Fucker.
Yeah, door opening match.
This is pretty cool. I've never seen this before.
Yeah, fight the thumb wrestler. That fat booty! That booty!
Yes! Oh my god!
That was really fast. What the fuck is this emote?
I'm Rob.
Just kidding. You guys gonna watch The Ridiculous Six on Netflix?
Mm-hmm. The do-over wasn't bad.
Was it not?
I thought it was way better than that other movie they made or whatever for Netflix with Adam Sandler.
What's the do-over?
It's a Netflix-only movie with Adam Sandler and David Spade.
No.
They basically fake their own deaths to start a new life. And that's all I'm going to give away to you.
Oh, well, there's too much to spoil in it.
It was pretty funny. Wasn't bad. I liked Adam Sandler's character in that movie.
The Ridiculous Six was hilarious? Really? No. I'm gonna say I doubt that.
No, it just isn't. I haven't seen it, but I know it is.
The Ridiculous Shits.
Oh, wait, that's the other movie on Netflix, huh?
Yeah, it's a movie from the perspective of any hotel at PAX. Oh, yeah. We didn't do this. Grab us! I'll Nick, grab us!
I'll help!
Oh, dear God! Go. I grabbed somebody too, and now we're flying.
No, we did it right. That's fine.
That was great.